And good evening, everyone. Welcome to Freeholders Forum, the show produced by the Union County Board of Chosen Freeholders to keep you, the residents of Union County, up to date on things that are going on. I'm your host, Wayne Avery, and as always, a pleasure to be with the Freeholder Chairman, Linda Carter.
Thank you.
Madam Chairman, always a pleasure to be here. Let's get started. We had a lot of fun over the taping this show a few days after the 4th of July, and I had a lot of fun. First of all, the jumping ahead on the 6th of July, we were marching in the Plainfield parade.
Absolutely. Again, once again, Plainfield held their annual parade, this time not on the 4th, but actually on the 6th of July, and it was truly, truly spectacular. You know, you had lots of residents out there seeing. We had balloons, we had bands, we had different organizations who participated. We had also a lot of bands that came in from other towns also that helped participate and make this one of the best parades that we've had in a long time.
Yeah, that was the first time that that I had the opportunity to be there, and I was very pleasantly surprised, I guess I should say, the number of people who lined the parade route, despite the fact that it was so warm out.
It was very warm because it was over 90 degrees that entire time. And, you know, when you had individuals out there, they were out there with their chairs, they had their umbrellas to shield some of the shade, but they truly had a great, great time the entire day. And then after the parade, a couple hours later, they did have over at Cedarbrook Park, they had concerts in the park. Where they had local talent that they were able to showcase, and then they topped the evening off with a spectacular fireworks show.
Mm-hmm. And I have to give kudos to you, by the way. Not only did you march once with the Freeholder Board, but turned around and
I turned right back around, and I went back to the beginning of the where the parade started, and actually marched with an organization, National Panhellenic Council of Central Jersey, which is a representation of the sororities and fraternities, the Divine Nine, here in the county and around Central Jersey.
So it was a good time, and of course, you know, keeping on the theme of the 4th of July, on the 4th, we, of course, taping the show at the Union County College in Cranford, right across the street from here in Nomahagan Park, was also a great time for us residents of the county.
Absolutely. Cranford did a spectacular day. You know, 4th of July, they had their canoe race, they had their 5K walk, they really did some wonderful activities throughout the day on the 4th. And then at the evening, what they ended up doing was also having the fireworks. And I was able to attend for those fireworks. Even though the day before, it was torrential rains, and it poured and all. But you know what? Our county stepped up to the plate, along with, you know, the government municipality of Cranford, and worked collectively to make sure that we can have all the activities on the 4th going and showing the spectacular fireworks that night also.
So the the summer did get off to a good start. As the show moves forward, we'll talk a little bit more about some of the things that are going on, will be going on here in the county. But as you mentioned, 90 degree weather, and we have been going through a heat wave. Hopefully when people watch the show, that heat will be gone. But I think we should let people know, because as the time has gone on with the heat there, that people can look at our website and listen to the alerts about cooling stations and things like that, because we did have a really, really oppressive heat wave come through, and it's early.
It's early. It really is. We had the week where it was high 90s, humidity is very high. And when you have heat like that in so many consecutive days, many of the municipalities have cooling stations. So if you're checking your local cable stations for what's going on in your particular town, but also go to your local websites for your municipality, but also go to the county website, www.ucnj.org, and look, because we make sure that we update it consistently to have the information out there, and we'll post what cooling stations are out there. And we want to make sure our residents stay cool if they need help in that manner. If it's too hot and it's humidity and the heat is that high for that long, please check it out and get to one of our cooling stations. Okay. Also, we need the residents to check on their neighbors. Check on, you know, what your elderly neighbors, check on your young youth neighbors. Find out, make sure that they have everything that they need and that they're okay.
Okay. Let's talk a couple of things, talk about some of the initiatives that you had. We'll check up and see how some of those are going. One of the things was Union County Means Business. The last segment of that you had was Women Mean Business in Union County. How did that event go?
Well, I'm going to tell you something. We started this initiative actually last year under Chairman Mirabella at that time, where we had Union County Means Business. I've carried it over this year in particular because of what it really is giving to our residents, giving to our business owners. You know, and when we have economic times, especially that we're in now, we need to make sure that everyone is aware of all the resources. But one initiative that I asked and made sure that we wanted to incorporate was one segment that was dedicated by and for women. And that's exactly what it was. And it was overwhelmingly a success. We had 250 women that came. We also had some men there, okay? But we had 250 women that showed up. They were energized. They were re-energized. They were reintroduced to many of the tools that they've had. They were introduced to tools that they have not seen before in order to empower them to go out and really take hold of some of their businesses. You know what? Also giving them an opportunity. Listen, if I'm thinking about starting a business, here I am. Here's what I can do. And really getting them on that track. And it was a huge success.
So that comes on top of the other programs that you've had. And so
absolutely,
all this has been a very successful program.
It really has. They've done two Union County Means Business seminars prior to, and they were breakfast where they came and were able to get information. This one actually took place. It started at 11 o'clock. It went until 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We held it over at Galloping Hill, over at the golf course at our clubhouse, in which the facility has been utilize where, guess what, one of the biggest things we have to understand is networking. So we also gave an opportunity to give golf lessons to individuals, and we had over 60 women that signed up to go out and take golf lessons, and they did that prior to coming to our day of workshops, and it was very, very well received. And people are asking us to make sure that we continue it for next year.
I was going to say, so it has been successful, as you mentioned. It started a year ago under the then Freeholder Mirabella, and now through you, and hopefully, you know, because of the success of it, because as we talk about it, you know, and there might be some of those who say, well, what is this all about? And you know, it's all about getting people to know what the services are and how to be able to do business.
How you're able to do business in the county, how you're able to do business outside of the county, what your resources are available to you. You may have an idea for a business, and you know what, you need a business loan. So we're bringing partners together to give you the tools and necessary resources. The one that we held in June was particularly geared around women and empowering women, because that was one of the initiatives that I set forth at the beginning of the year. We want to make sure that we're moving forward. What we are also going to be doing, and hopefully we will get a group of individuals together to also try to work on doing something empowering our youth, and also doing, you know what, maybe we can do a Union County Youth Mean Business also, and really stem off of there and have all aspects, making sure that we have them covered. And you know what? What better county to do business in than Union County?
Okay, so hopefully that will continue on through next year. Let's talk about another initiative that you had, and as we are taping this, we're 2 days away from it, but we can talk about the reasoning why you're doing it, and that is the gun buyback, which is going to take place this coming weekend.
And yes, it will.
Talk a little bit about that, why you think that this is something that's important for us to have here in Union County.
One of the things that we've seen over in our country, in the state, is the rise in violence. And one thing that, you know what, we have to make sure that guns, people that utilize guns, they have to be utilized in the right manner, and they have to be in the right hands. Our law enforcement need to have our guns, okay? We need to make sure that we are well protected, but we also, as citizens, want to be well protected. We have some that people that are gun collectors that are no longer utilizing guns. If they feel as if, you know what, an opportunity, they don't want it anymore, we have a safe haven where they can turn that in. This Friday, which is July 12th, and Saturday, July 13th, from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., we are, Union County, having a gun buyback program where anyone anonymously can come in and, you know what, turn a gun in. We want to get as many guns off of the street. We've had a lot of violence, and we've had a lot of youth violence. We want to make sure that our youth don't have access to these guns and not using them in the proper manner. We want to get them off of the streets.
Okay, and we'll talk more about that and talk about how successful that it was the next time we get together. Our final topic, in this segment, as I guess everyone knows, hopefully, Everyone knows, coming up, we have a couple of special elections that are coming up in August, primary election, and in October, a special election for the Senate. And that has been something where the Freeholder Board has had to deal with a couple of circumstances, such as funding.
Absolutely.
Which we've never had to deal with before. Let's talk a little bit about that in a couple minutes that we have left in the first segment.
The governor has called for a special election for the Senate race, in which we will have for the primary in August, and then of course, just like you mentioned, we will have for the general Senate race in October. Well, when it comes in October, then right behind October is November, where we will have our general election, where it goes from the governor on down to all of your local races. And one of the things that's happening is we as a Freeholder Board, you know what, we have to make sure the state funds most of this, and we will get some reimbursement back from them. And we had to approve a couple of weeks ago funding to make sure that all the information is out there, ballots are printed, and that our county clerk, Joanne Rajapi, has the necessary time frame to get the job done and making sure everybody has an opportunity to exercise their right. Our Freeholder Board, you know what, looked at it and said we are not funding the entire amount. We weren't sure. There was a lot of still conversation around. We had not gotten full direction from the state on how they will be handling this. So we only funded a portion at this point to handle for the primary that will be held in August. We want to make sure that, you know what, our clerk has enough, but it's going to cost us a lot of money. This election, this special election, you know what, is going to cost a lot of money. The state is forcing us because we have to pay the poll workers for both of those. We also have to open up the schools. Many of the schools are utilized and they're on vacation during that time frame. So the schools will have to be opened up for us to make sure that the polling places are there. So we want to make sure that we had enough time and everything. Our budgets also were already set. So we have to also go back and figure out where this money is going to come from. So we have a lot of challenges ahead of us, but you know, we do have the special election, that primary, which is in August.
Okay, yep, that's just right around the corner. This first segment has flown by. Wasn't sure that we're going to go through this far, but we do have a lot more to talk about. We're going to talk about what's going on in our parks over the summertime. We'll do that when we come back. So stay with us until we return.
Laura says we should start worrying about drinking at these things.
They're only 12.
I know. I'm just glad you know better, sweetheart.
You're too smart for that, right, honey?
Real kids are curious about alcohol. 40% tried by the 8th grade. Talk early, talk often, get others involved.
And we welcome you back to Freeholders Forum. I'm Wayne Avery, along with the chairman of the Freeholder Board, Linda Cotter. Start segment number two. We're joined by the director of Parks and Community Renewal, Ron Zuber. Ron, welcome back to our show.
Good to be here, Wayne.
You know, let's, you know, we started out talking about the 4th of July and all the heat that we've had.
And the kickoff to the summer.
And the kickoff to the summer. And thankfully, the kids and grown-ups have a lot of different options during the summer, but probably the biggest and most popular, I guess, has to be the our swimming pools. So, Ron, why don't we start off talking a little bit about what we have to offer as far as swimming is concerned.
Wayne, the County of Union offers the residents two swimming pools. One is in Linden Wheeler Pool. The other one is Ulrich Pool in Rahway. Wheeler Pool is a little bit smaller, it is really well attended, and we hit capacity there a little bit sooner than we would over in Rahway. But the Rahway pool has a dive tank, which is very popular also, and it's an Olympic-sized swimming pool. As we were talking before about cooling stations throughout the county, Wheeler also, we supply our residents who have to wait in line there with tents and misters outside. The sun beats down pretty hard outside at Wheeler. The entrance is under a tree and covered. That's just another little amenity we try to offer our patrons, because it's been hot this summer, and it's not like we have to sell. Please come to the pools. People are coming right now.
Yeah. What are the hours that the pools are open?
The pools vary. I like to say we close both Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at 6 p.m. But Monday and Wednesdays at Rahway Pool, we open at 11 and close at 8. And Tuesday and Thursday, we open at 11 and close at 6. And at Wheeler Pool in Linden, on Monday and Wednesdays, we open at 1 and close at 6. And Tuesdays and Thursdays, we open at 1 and close at 8.
And you mentioned that these are very, very well attended pools.
Very well attended pools, and on top of that, Wayne, the county right now has 6 functioning spray parks. They're at Matano Park in Elizabeth. They're in the Rizzuto Park, which is straddles the Union Hillside Elizabeth border. Snyder Park in Berkeley Heights. The Ponderosa out in Scotch Plains, and within days of this taping, we'll have one functioning up at the Loop Playground also, and one at Cedarbrook Park in Plainfield.
Absolutely, and we needed those spray parks this past weekend too.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I mean, it gives us opportunity. I mean, we talk about the swimming pools, and you know, the kids are able to jump around, but parents can bring their kids to these spray, and they've become pretty much popular over the last several years for people to bring their kids to.
Absolutely.
Let's talk also, you know, Wednesdays have always been a fun time for those people who, you know, spend a day working and want to go and hang out in the park. A lot of things to do for them on Wednesday nights with our summer concert series.
The Family Fun and Flicks concert series, I believe, Wayne, is in its 9th year. Don't quote me on that, but real close. We're already in the middle of it. The upcoming movies, you could find all of this information on the county website under parks at ucnj.org. But coming up on July 16th at Warnaco Park is Hotel Transylvania. On the 23rd is Brave. Every year we celebrate National Night Out with a movie, and this year it's August 6th. That will be at Mizell Park in Springfield. Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs. And on Tuesday, August 13th, our final one of the year, is Madagascar 3. That is at Conan Park in Hillside. Each one of these movies is accompanied by the Trailside Nature and Science Center Echo Van. I'm sorry. And kids have a chance to interact with live animals, museum type pieces that we bring down. It's a good treat for people who do get there early and do bring their blankets and stake out a spot early. There's something to do. And we have refreshments there, and the vendor who brings the movies also supplies popcorn.
Yeah, I was going to say that when we talk about the movies, people think, okay, it's dark out and we'll go see the movies. But people do come early. I remember being there and watching the people coming over the hills at the Warnaco Park and other places, and the entertainment there that the kids are able to take advantage of during that time. Mm-hmm. How about the concerts that are...
Once again, we're in the middle of our concert season, which has started on July 10th. July 17th, we're going to have a band called American Rapture there, which plays a variety of 60s, 70s, and 80s music. July 24th, it will be Eagle Mania. You can guess what kind of music they'll be playing. On July 31st, we'll have Big Ed Palermo Band. I'd like to say that those three concerts are all at Echo Lake Park in Mountainside. There'll be a county department represented at each one. You can come out and meet the individuals who run certain departments, for anything from Bureau of Recycling to Bureau of Mosquito Control. You get to talk to them, learn some things about what we offer. On August 7th, we moved the concert series to Oak Ridge Park in Clark. Tusk will be playing. That is a Fleetwood Mac tribute band. The Sensational Soul Cruisers the following Wednesday. The Verdict, which is a reggae influenced band, will be playing there on the 21st, and we close up with the British Invasion on August 28th.
And I think it was good to mention the fact that the Freeholder van will be there, because when we talk about information that people can have about what's going on around the county, they can find out just about anything that they want to find out that's going on in the county on that van.
Absolutely. There's a lot wealth of information, and another initiative that we were trying to do is take our van and also go green. So we have a lot of information also that we should have via website. And we're hoping to have the computer up and running and sitting right there that somebody can actually go online and look some information up.
So it's a very good thing there. We have the pools, we have the movies that are going on, but there are other things that are going on also during the day that can keep the kids entertained and also educated, I guess, as well.
Wayne, we have a very successful summer camp program being run by the Trailside Science and Nature Center, and also right around the corner, if you will, the Watch Young Stables. There is all types of events going on for families of young children and up at Trailside. The Wednesday matinee is a very big series. It's something that we do promote, but it's something that also gets filled up quickly. Just every Wednesday starting July 10th, so we're in the middle of that right now, there's going to be a different performance. Kids in Motion is going to be there July 17th. On the 24th will be Eyes Wild. It's about zoos and habitats and a variety of survival strategies for interesting mammals. Hocus Pocus, obviously that's a magic show, going to be on the 31st. Bubble Trouble, which is a fun one. I've seen it last year. Probably one of the more popular ones, is on August 7th. And finally, The Brain Show. It's like a TV show, game show for kids, and it's very interactive with the people in the audience. And it's great because it's the kids there having a great time, and it's either the parents or grandparents there having just as good a time. And a wonderful time inside, but air-conditioned, and a great thing.
Yeah, I think that's probably the one of the important things, is that when you talk about the programs that are put together, that they're not just just send your kid there and we'll babysit during the time, that these are actually educational programs as well.
Absolutely. These programs that they're running are truly things that enhance a lot of things that our kids have learned in school, or getting them interested in some of the things and seeing Trailside. I'm amazed at some of the things that they have been able to do. So there's a lot of stuff going on, a lot of things that they can do.
Wayne, as a parent of little guys, if you saw my son today when he was at Trailside, you would say, you're not getting in my car. But you know what? He was out there. He was out in the woods. He was out in the water. He was scooping things up and bringing back shoeboxes full of stuff, and had a great time, and it was well worth the hosing down my wife had to give him once we got home. So.
You mentioned a little bit about the stables. There's a lot of things that are going now. That's a lot of the things that we talk about, and it's good that we're able to talk about and point people to our website, is that they're kind of like hidden treasures there.
Absolutely.
Things like the stables. A lot of people probably just say, well, what do I care about the stables and things like that? But there are a lot of things that people can do, bring their kids, and they can learn a lot about what's going on there.
Watch Young Stables offers a variety of of different types of horse riding for beginners, people who own their own horses. We have boarders up there. It currently houses 89 horses. We have been focusing this year on trail rides. Our trails got hit really, really hard with the hurricane. And we went out there, cleaned them up. We're offering trail rides, we're offering lessons. We have certified instructors up there, and it's just bringing up a whole new audience of riders to the Watchung Stables.
Mm-hmm. You know, the chairman mentioned not long ago, and why are you giggling? He was mentioning about the golf. And let's talk about golf. Golf, I mean, you know, everybody's out there who, you know, wants to go out even in 90-degree weather.
90-degree weather is hard, but it's still so beautiful. It is absolutely gorgeous out on the golf course.
It's wonderful. We have two golf courses, Ashbrook and Scotch Plains and Galloping Hill. Galloping Hill has undergone a lot of work. I'm from around here. I've golfed there since I was a kid, and I went out there recently, and it's just amazing. The work has been done from the tees to the tee boxes to the actual fairways. The learning center is magnificent. I was talking to another individual who I've seen recently, and how we used to sneak onto the pitch and putt right over there where the learning center is right now. But you've got 54 stalls, some of them heated. You can ride by the parkway at night and see those lights on, and it's really well utilized, there's nothing bad you could say about it. There's a 9-hole course out there also. The training center offers acres of area to just chip away. It's a great facility from top to bottom.
You mentioned, Chairman, that the women were out there hitting the balls. Were
you
out there too? Were you out there?
I have taken up golfing. I'm trying to learn it, and I'm trying to get out there. I'm not that good, but you know what? Doesn't
that's
matter.
Why, that's why we have the learning center.
That's right. I'm going to get out there, and I'm going to hit a golf ball.
We are just about near the end of our show. Another great show to talk about things that are going on in the county. And Ron, we appreciate you taking time out, because we know that this is the busy time in parks, to be with us.
No problem. Thank you.
And thank
Madam
you so
Chairman,
much.
It's always a pleasure to be here with you, and we'll do it again very soon.
Why, thank you so much, and I hope you have a great birthday next week.
Thank you very much.
Anytime.
That's going to do it for Freeholders Forum for this edition. I'm Wayne Avery for the Chairman, Jimmy Carter, and for our guest, Ron Zuber. We'll see you next time.